Yay!
Yeah, this is weird. Literally, it looks like a fucking sack on me. Not. She's beauty and she's grace. She's Miss United States. Litty bop, as my Gen Zers would say. Nope.
Oh, I look insane!
Do I look like I've worked out today? No. Do I have a mustache? What's up, everybody? Oh, I'm so pale. Well, that's about to change because I'm in a spray tan this week, but let me turn this down even though the song is so good. So, started out my morning because I'm leaving for my bachelorette this week. So, this video is going to be very short and most likely will be combined with next week's video because I have a really crazy 2 weeks, but I'm very excited about it. So this week, I leave on Thursday for my best friend since first grade's bachelorette party. We're going to Florida, and I'm very excited, but my body needs to get in gear. So this week, what I'm going to be doing is a lot of de-bloating, anti-inflammatory meals, whatever, just because the following week, I'm in my other best friend's wedding and got my dress fitted last week and really just wasn't feeling amazing. So I was like, you know what, I just need to get it together. So juices all week, not doing a juice cleanse. Also, it's a little tart today. If you guys watched my last video, I don't know, when I made a juice, like you're supposed to strain it because I don't have a juicer, so I do it in the blender, and it just was chunky and gross, but it's crazy that I did my best. I don't really have a strain. I have a colander, so I did my best with that, but I need like a really small mesh strainer, so I'm gonna get one of those today. But lemon water to set the body up in the morning. I don't remember all the benefits, I just know it's good for you, for your body in the morning. And then we're doing a little green juice action. Same recipe as the last one, except I added a little ginger today. But I'm gonna make my grocery list and my to-do list for today. I want to get a lot accomplished today because tomorrow, I'll show you guys what I'm doing, but a lot of it requires me to not be at home. So just really getting in gear for leaving to be in a bathing suit all weekend. Don't you just love that? I'm like, I'm gonna do like a 2 week cleanse, just like really healthy, except for smack dab in the middle, I'm going to a bachelorette party and drinking lots of alcohol. So it is what it is, but let's make the to-do list and whatever. Clearly I eat more than this because I haven't gone to the store yet. I haven't really done much. I've been sitting here trying to do the playlist. I don't know how the fuck I've like dicked away all this time, but yeah, I'm about to head out. Well, after I eat this and then, shit, I got a lot to do and it's almost 1 o'clock. Literally, where did the day go? I did sleep in a little bit today, but whatever. So yeah, I'm about to finish up tomorrow's playlist. And then I'm gonna head out, head to Zara, and then take you guys with me wherever I go. But like I said, I'm eating this now to kind of hold myself over as my lunch because I don't have enough to like make a smoothie for lunch. I don't know, it's not that I have to have a smoothie every day, it's just that I have to be like smart about what I'm putting in my body. I'm just kind of anal about it, which, or I just should have done better over the past, I don't know, 2 months. Mm-hmm. Alrighty, I am off to Zara. This is what I'm wearing. Have my return in here. It's only like 60 degrees out today. I'm doing the whole tuck your sweatshirt in your bra thing, which is like a crop top, but I could quickly see myself pulling it down, so whatever. Just in the front, but here we are, dressed like it's effing winter, I feel like, so that's annoying, but off we go. Alrighty guys, show you the haul when I get home. I have no idea if Zara's like this anywhere where you're from, but the one I go to, always, never fails. You are waiting in line for at least 20 minutes to check out. I don't know, I have no idea why. My God, going to Trader Joe's now.
Yogi vlog, just got back from Trader Joe's. This is such a healthy haul.
Pat's self went back.
Actually, I'm gonna be gone all weekend too, so I probably overbought stuff, but whatever. Produce, yada yada. Really quick run through. All right, so keeping it super basic, lots of things for juices, smoothies, etc. So it's basically all produce, plus the only meats I got this week were salmon and chicken, helping for anti-inflammatory. Got some frozen pineapple and blueberries, coconut water for the juices, granola for me and work for Will. All of the greens, tomatoes, got different RX bars and Clif bars this week. And then lots of cucumber because I had that a lot with either the juices or just in general. Sweet potatoes, avocados, celery. We got our berries and then we actually have a whole thing of blueberries in there. Needed some new seasoning, lemons. Those are for Will. And that's yogurt back there and tuna. And this is such a basic haul. But hey, I don't hate it. So now what I'm gonna do is, oh, show you guys this is our haul and then I have to edit the podcast before I leave for class, so we'll do that. Okay, so I'm gonna do my Zara haul, but I'm gonna do it for my Instagram stories, but you guys are gonna get the picture, okay? Okay, Zara haul. This is just kind of like random stuff that I've either been wanting or getting. So I returned a pair of jeans and got another pair instead. So I'm super excited about these. They're called the Slim Flare. I'm gonna try on all of these for my YouTube video, but very cute, very promising. And then I got this fun little satiny dress. It's got like paisley details on it, potentially for the rehearsal dinner of the wedding that I'm in, but TBD on that, but it's very cute and pretty. And then I got these shorts because if you guys have been following along, I'm like obsessed with the like mint green right now. So thinking these could be a cute little moment. But like I said, I have to try everything on. And then what else did I get? Oh, fully influenced by Chandler to buy this sweater situation. It's like this lime green sweater, but I got it in a large, like oversized. So could wear it with shorts, could wear it with jeans, but very, very cute, but chunky sweater. Once again, have to try it on. And then two more things. So this stuff's mainly for the trip I'm about to go on. They have really cute like basic tops in there. So head to Zara if you want. So this is just like this little crisscross neck moment. Kind of like the color that I'm wearing now, just a little bit more brown. I just feel like these tops are very in right now. So definitely like that. I am such a sucker for a basic white ribbed wife beater essentially, but I really liked the cut of this one. I just have so many of these from Brandy Melville, but they're just not great quality, so had to get another one of those. And then last but not least, I got this like linen tan shirt, kind of for like a beach cover-up moment, but it's buttoned so I can't put it on right now. And that is my Zara haul, so I have to try it all on in my YouTube video, which I'm filming right now, and then we'll see if it fits and what I need to return.
True food, love your mother.
Oh. Totally different person.
I got great story. I got what I always get, the ancient greens bowl.
Okay guys, it is Tuesday. I am off to get my hair cut. It is so long and pretty gross. I'm whispering because Will got his vaccination on Sunday. It's now Tuesday, I just said that. And he feels like shit. Literally like vomiting and like fever chills, which I felt like shit the next day, but nothing like that. So he's home from work, but this is what I'm wearing today. These are my Good American jeans, I love them. And then I'll just wear my Air Force Ones and I will take you guys with me. I'm really excited to go though, and the girl apparently is amazing. My friend Jessie recommended her to me, and her reviews on Yelp are really, really good. So I'm excited. I'm not doing anything really fancy, but I do think I'm gonna get curtain bangs in the sense of like very long ones. So I really need to eat something before I go. LOL at Remy B being one of my like inspo pictures. I just wanna be able to do this with my hair. I'm gonna show her Savon's hair in the sense of like look how long her layers are in the front, and then keep the length. Like these are too short probably, but yeah, just a little more volume. That girl's like, they're long.
All right guys, so just got back from my haircut and I'm actually obsessed with it. Hold on, let me show you. So I asked her to do like long curtain bangs or like long layers. So I'm happy because she kept so much of the length on. She probably only took off about 3 inches and it just feels a lot healthier, a lot cleaner, nicer, and I'm happy about it. And she was like, I want you to come back in 3 months so I can do a little maintenance trim because apparently that makes your hair healthier. And fun fact, because I was telling her about all the issues with my hair, she was like, yeah, you're using a shampoo and conditioner for color treated hair.
so I'm an idiot, and have to switch that up, and she gave me like a clarifying shampoo to kind of like fix my hair for the next month. But you know that feeling when your hair is just so soft and clean? But I really like these short little things because I think it's gonna give me more dimension and stuff when I do my hair. But here it is. And now I'm rushing. I have to eat dinner and eat dinner. I have to eat lunch and head to an appointment. So I'll catch up with you guys when I can. Okie dokie, guys. I am back. Such a mess of a time. When is it not with me, right? I basically had to drive an hour home to go get my IUD checked, you know, post whatever. If you haven't watched that vlog, you're in for a real treat. But because there was just so much traffic that it took me an hour and a half to get somewhere that it normally takes me 45 minutes. So I'm calling, I'm like, hey, I'm gonna be 10 minutes late, really early, like literally 45 minutes before my appointment. And then they're like, oh, like if you're in a 15 minute window, you're gonna have to reschedule. If you're not in the 15 minute window. I'm like, awesome. So then it's putting me there at 4:01. 15 minutes after my appointment. So I'm like, fuck. So I call, I'm like, hey, what do you want me to do? And they're like, hey, you're gonna have to reschedule. Me, already so far away from home. So I'm like, okay, great. So then they get back on the phone with me because they like put me on hold to like reschedule my appointment. They're like, actually, we're gonna check with the doctor if she wants you to come in. Me knowing that this appointment is literally gonna take 2 minutes, which it did. They're like, okay, just come in. Thank God, because I was not trying to reschedule this. So then I get there, and they're like, hey, your insurance isn't working. I'm like, what the fuck? Because I went back to work. So basically, my furlough insurance went through the end of March. So I conveniently scheduled this appointment after May 1st because I knew I should be in the clear, right? Unless they did May 15th. I went back to work April 13th. So then I just had to pay out of fucking pocket for this appointment. Yay! And as I'm fucking sitting there like waiting, I'm like drafting up an email. I'm like, hello, where are my benefits? So that was fun. I'm fucking starving. And I'm gonna go home now, literally because I need to get a little travel steamer for my trip this week. So. Oh, and I'm starving.
Hello, hello. It's the next day. Yes, my hair is pulled back. I slept with it up with like this light scrunchie because she was like, oh, it may keep its curl. My hair doesn't keep its curl. But looking like a hot mess. But I decided I'm going to try on, sorry, that's the dryer, the stuff from Zara the other day and my triangle bathing suit. Probably not gonna show you guys the triangle bathing suit. Like on, if I like it, you'll see it in an Instagram post. But I wanna do that now because then I'm gonna do a bar workout. I just have so much to get done today. And I don't know if you're like me, but I get severe like packing anxiety, or it's funny. I think it's packing anxiety. It's not so much travel anxiety as it is packing. It's like, I'm a compulsive overpacker and it just really stresses me out. And even this, like it's like Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and we come home Sunday. So it's like, what do I really need? But it's like, no, I really only need 2 or 3 bathing suits, but I'm going to take 8. You know, like I really only need like 2 to 4 outfits. I'm going to take 9, 10. I'm trying not to. I have my packing cubes, but people are trying to get away with the carry-on, and I'm like, there is no way I'm being able to do this with a carry-on. So we'll see. I look so disgusting. I cannot wait to get a spray tan. Like, I've been putting off putting on anything. You can't tell how pale I am because I want to go like as fresh as I can. So speaking of tan, this finally came, but I'm getting a spray tan. So my favorite go-to self-tanner is just the Loving Tan Dark. I just like it. I've used it for years and I've tried so many others. I've tried the drops and rubs. I like the drops for my face, but nothing tans my body the way Loving Tan does. Like nothing else like gives me the color I want. Nothing else, like a lot of other things are too orange, too streaky. So that, and then if you saw my Hollister haul in the last video, yes, I said Hollister, I got these in a medium and then I just felt like they were a little too big. So I exchanged them for a small. They're the Gilly Hicks Seamless Sage biker shorts. And then I actually just got this package from Sweaty Betty. It's the Halle Berry edit, which is kind of cool. Yeah, so it's like the little Halle Berry set. It's like this high neck
bra and then biker shorts. I guess it's like Sweaty Betty, Halle Berry, because you can tell it's like an H. And then this little bag, but very nice.
Okay, so this top is inappropriate without something underneath of it, but this is my triangle suit. I actually don't like it. So I have this same suit. It's called the Mika. It's the sparkly one in gold, and I really like it, but this green is not the green that I was looking for. Just no. So I'm returning that. This is the top I got from Zara. If I pull my hair in front, it won't be inappropriate. But I do like the neckline of it, but it's very thin. So TBD if I'm keeping this. I really like these, and I'm glad I exchanged them because I think they fit a lot better. So I will keep. Okay, so I really like this top. I love that. I would definitely wear this top with jeans. Like, this is how I envisioned it, so I figured I'd put on the Zara jeans with it, which I also think are a win, which makes me happy. I just really love the color. They have some distressing in the knees, and they have, I'll show you because it's hard to see here, but definitely really like this top. With the tan, it'll look really good. But the jeans have that like weird slit at the bottom, so I can shorten them a little bit, but they're distressed in the knees, and I just really like the color of them. I don't know if my face has been in this frame one time, but I definitely like this, and I'm gonna keep both of these for sure. And I'm definitely gonna take this top with me. TBD on the jeans, because I'll probably just take my good American jeans. But yay for these jeans fitting and working. Okay, Zara. All right, moving on. Why do I keep thinking I'm hitting play and I'm not, or record? So I got this shirt as a beach cover up, but obviously it's like very cropped, which makes me a little insecure about my hip area. But I did get this in a long sleeve from Pretty Little Thing. Pretty sure it's not coming in time to leave tomorrow. But I like it as just a regular shirt. I think you could definitely wear it as a regular shirt, but I also think I could wear it with like sweat shorts as like a beach cover up, and it would be very cute. So I'm definitely gonna keep it, but I do think it was overpriced for what it is. Okay, hear me out. I need to move this down. I think that this big ass sweater has potential. Obviously not the way I'm wearing it right now. Like, maybe if you would tuck the front or something. I mean, I got it in a large, and I don't want anyone underneath it. Maybe I should have gotten a medium because it's pretty oversized. I was thinking that this could potentially also be a cover up, but it kind of looks like a sack on me. But I think if I styled it correctly, it could work in a way. I mean, I'm trying to picture what it would look like with jean shorts. Yeah, so I'm gonna stick a pin in this. I love the color. Yeah, this is weird. Literally, it looks like a fucking sack on me. It looks like when you used to play, or when I used to play basketball, and you'd get like the extra, extra, extra large penny to wear. Some people call them, you know, they're like jerseys. What do people call those fucking things? I don't know, we always just call them pennies. You know, the little fucking things you put on. Comment down below what you call those, because I feel like there's another name I'm like really missing. But yeah, the little mesh jerseys. So, yeah, I don't know. So for the record, I'm just so pale that everything is frightening when I put it on, because I'm, you know, we're not used to wearing shorts yet. And you know, like when you put your first shorts on in the season, you're like, holy shit, I'm so pale and my legs are so hairy. These shorts, I actually really like them. They just make me feel extremely washed out right now, but they're a little bit longer. It's funny, they label these as Bermuda shorts, which is hilarious to me, because Bermuda shorts go to like here. But I like the little slit in the side, and it just like kind of opens up the butt area. So I definitely like these, and I think they'll look really good with a white crop all summer, but I'm definitely not going to be taking these with me, because bachelorette, I shouldn't be wearing white. So that really limits my wardrobe, because if you know me, I wear white, gray, black, and that's about it. And typically it's a white top. So here we are. Okay, lastly, I bought this dress to potentially wear to the rehearsal dinner of the wedding I'm in next weekend. But to be honest, when I got it, I thought the back was the front. So it does like the little V, but this has like this little fake ruching, which I don't like that I can't tighten it, because I feel like it just sits too high based on where I need the straps to be. And I actually tried it on backwards and like it better backwards, but then this just hangs really weird in the back. So
I don't hate it. Like, I like the idea of wearing a satin dress to the rehearsal dinner, but I don't love it enough to think that I should keep it. Yeah. I don't know. Like, it's cute, but it's just, there's something about it that I'm just like, I don't like the way this sits at all. It still sits weird. I don't know. So, no matter what, all this stuff, I need a tan. But that's the Zara haul. I am going to continue to pack, but first I'm gonna do some bar because I need to work out.
Yeah. I realize I like kind of hate all my bathing suits, and I really only got like these two new ones. If you watch the haul, this is from 437. This is just not my color. I'm not taking all of these. I'm just staring at the four of these to think about it because I'm giving this one to the bride. So
I also realized I don't love any of my black suits. The bottoms are just too worn, and my 437 top, just, I don't like how booby it makes me look. Really should have been on that, but I really only need two suits, so I'll probably wear the green one day. And then, like, I feel like I have other suits that I like, and I don't, maybe I'll take my gold one. I like my white suit, but I can't wear my white suit. So, I don't know. I'll probably wear my lavender one day and the green one. Maybe I'll take my gold one. But I also have to think, like, if I'm at the beach, I should probably go and take, like, a shitload of pictures. Dude, I don't know. I'm fucking over it. What's up? Mental state. Wanted to do bar. Haven't done it yet because I'm like, you know what? I'll get everything done that I need to get done and then do it. Bad idea. Don't mind Victoria talking in the background. I'm listening to today's podcast episode because, yes, I do listen to all of them after, because we record them, then I edit them, and then some of our platform that we upload from does some mix mastering, so I always just want to hear what it sounds like final, and I'm very happy about it just because our volumes were quite different when I was editing and had to do a lot of work on my end, so I'm happy that it sounds really good, and I really hope that people like it. I think it's an episode that's very helpful to a lot of people. It's interesting, obviously, to Soulcycle riders when she talks about that part, but it's not just about Soulcycle. It's just, I just really think it's a great episode, personally. I need to rub off any excess self-tanner. I have like this weird dot on my forehead before I get my spray tan tonight, but I'm just stressed. I'm just trying to relax. My friend's like, you barely need anything, like bathing suits, cover-ups, and like a few outfits. I'm like, that's a lot of stuff. So literally this is my like yes stuff, minus the suits. I have to figure out what the fuck's going on with those. And this is my like maybe pile, like, but I'm waiting for packages to come today, so it's making it very fucking difficult. So sorry, I'm losing my mind, but I'm okay. Once I finish this little thing, I'm gonna run out the one thing I have to run out and do today, and then I think I'll be able to breathe a little, because then packing is just like, put in the packing cubes and pack it, Kallie. You'll survive. Oh my goodness, you guys, I just got back. So I have about an hour and a half before I have to leave for class. I have to tweak my playlist a little bit. I'm literally sweating my nuts off right now. Sorry if that made you uncomfortable, that's just a saying I say. My back. I really haven't eaten a lot today. It's really not good for me, but most of my packages came that I have been waiting for. Unfortunately, Princess Polly didn't come and my Pretty Little Thing didn't come, which means, so annoying. However, I forgot that I ordered stuff from ASOS, which makes me happy because it can pass as a beach cover-up or what? Or an outfit. Let's have an opening party. But I also stopped and got matcha. I got staples, because I don't know if you guys are on TikTok, but I saw this really cute thing. A lot of people have been doing it while driving. Like, they're going to a bachelorette or something and they put their Venmo on it. It's like, buy the bride a drink, and people get a shitload of money for it. So then I was like, damn, I wish I could do that, but we're not driving, we're flying. So then I saw this TikTok the other day of this group of girls who flew. Mind you, they were walking through the airport in all pink sweatsuits, like a huge group of them. But they all had these labels on with the Venmo name and the Venmo like QR code. And I was like, fuck, I'm gonna do that. So if I don't get to it, I don't get to it. But it's my idea. I already made the labels. It's just the being able to make sure it's printed out correctly on them and that I have enough ink, but she's a beaut. She's beauty and she's grace. She's Miss United States. Whatever. Let's get to it.
I just realized I can't try on anything tonight because I'll have my spray tan.
Oh no. Oh no.
Another top.
Whoa.
This looks like a bandage.
Wow, hold on. I also have to send a video to my friend.
Look at this shirt that just came for me. Let's put it on. I don't think I'm gonna like it. God, why do my boobs look? Oh. So yeah, this is the shirt. Number one, it's pressing my boobs together all weird because of the sports bra. I think you just leave, do you leave it like that? You must tie it like this. One more little knot.
Oh, mm-mm.
Oh. So really on brand. Not.
You know what's funny is this shirt could have interesting potential. It's just, I'm not in the mood to wear a bra out.
So she will be returned. I hope you enjoyed this weird try-on haul. If you can't tell, I have my spray tan on. It is like 10 o'clock. What I didn't want. Let's see if this fits in here. These shoes are TBD. Good morning, it is Wednesday. Yes, so all of this is just gonna be combined together. I'll give you guys an update later, but I have to leave in about 10 minutes. I am subbing this morning. Picked it up and I regretted it when my alarm went off. But I've gotta get going, so I'll catch you guys up soon.
Okay guys, just a little update because I haven't been vlogging. Basically, I went away this weekend. And if you follow me on Instagram, I'm sure you saw that. I'm gonna make some fun TikToks about it because we just had literally the best time. We went to Destin, Florida for one of my best friend's bachelorettes, which I've been talking about for so long, and I can't believe it's already over. It was literally such a good weekend. So much fucking fun. I'm literally on like post-weekend depression withdrawal or something. But Monday was just, what the hell did I do Monday? Monday, I feel like I unpacked, like I just, you know, did a lot of like housekeeping things, shit like that. Oh, this woman's running to class. Good luck. Or no, she's not. Where is she running? I don't know. She's running somewhere. Is she running to class? Nope. Went past Soulcycle. Just taught, obviously. And God, I'm so out of it. I need to eat something really bad. Yeah, it was just such a great weekend. Then yesterday I taught and then I like did a lot of podcast stuff. So there was just no point in me vlogging. So I was like, I'll pick it up today, pick it up tomorrow and probably Friday and then end it because I'm so excited to be at one of my other best friends' weddings this weekend. So it's just been a really crazy 2 weeks, but I feel like I'm gonna be so upset when it's over because then it's gonna be like so much stuff you like anticipate and look forward to is just over. But I'm excited. I feel like I am doing a good amount of stuff today and that should be exciting for you guys to, I don't know, maybe watch with me, maybe not, I don't know. But got my gua sha yesterday and I need to go home and use it, but I have to stop at Sephora to get some face oil, which I'll show you guys. But anyway, it was such an epic weekend. It's just so great. But I just subbed
the 8:15. I'm exhausted, but I literally had half of a Clif Bar before class, which is really not good for me because I typically like to eat a lot before class. So with that being said, unfortunately, I think I'm gonna have to pick up like Starbucks or something because I don't have a lot of time before my next appointment. So I'll catch you guys on the flippity flip and show you what's up.
Also, can we talk about the like no mask thing anymore? Like, I don't even know what the hell the rules are.
Denise clearly didn't trust him either.
I literally don't know. I know places are choosing on their own. I don't know. But I did teach class this morning for the first time without a mask. It was so amazing. I just really need to eat something. I'm so out of it. Just picked up Starbucks because once again, if you guys have been watching the vlogs, I've been lazy and haven't ordered my matcha. I definitely have spent $50. I mean, I got 10 of them. I don't know. And then I got a breakfast sandwich because I'm fucking hungry and I need it. But I'm gonna go move my car because I'm getting a pedicure for the wedding this weekend. I'm doing the pedicure today because I'm getting my nails done. Guys, I still have these fucking nails. They're so grown out. But I want to get my nails done with my girl. And I was like, well, I only feel like driving home once this week, so I'm going to get them done Friday, which is the day of the rehearsal dinner. But it's fine. So, but need to get my toes done today for spray tan purposes because my nails should be fine. But the scrubs and stuff that they use on your feet, not good.
Well, so Sephora was a fail because my dumbass didn't check to see if they had the ordinary rose, what is it? Cold pressed rose hip seed oil mouthful. I wanted it for my gua sha to snatch my fucking jaw before this weekend, just a little bit. No. So they had to order it for me, which is nice of them. Also, I like have to wait till this man in the car behind me moves because he's parked so terribly. So hopefully he's about to do that. But that was a bummer, but they were so nice in there. And luckily she was like, oh, we'll just order it for you so you get free shipping. I'm like, perfect. Because you literally have like the ordinary, which is like $10. And then you have the next one, which is like $40. I'm like, no. Hot as balls outside. It's only 80 degrees and it's not even noon yet. Okay, I don't know if this guy's moving, but
I'll see. Scary because I put my hair back, but guys. Okay, so we can have masks off in class, but that was so fun. This is Jessie. You guys have seen her. She's very out of date with her,
Tis
you're wearing
season.
A fucking Santa Claus. It's May. But how fun was class?
It was psycho. It was unreal.
I played a few of Jessie's favorite songs and then mixed in some of my favorite songs and it turned out to be... It was literally one of my favorite classes.
Literally
since we
like
back.
Speechless.
So fun. Everyone was like, ah! And it was the first 6:30 where everyone could take their mask off. So I think people were just living. And I'm excited. Jonathan, do you want to say hi to the vlog?
Yeah, what's up, vlog?
Hi, vlog.
How we doing?
Hi, vlog. They're gonna reply back. Comment down below your response.
Happy Thursday, bitches. So I'm really excited because it's I'm so excited. So two of my best friends are getting married this weekend. In case you didn't know, because if you've been watching all my other vlogs, it's all I fucking talk about. It's all I'm preparing for. It's all I'm ordering shit for. So, I think I just got up too fast. So, talk class this morning, 9:30 was amazing. Last night was so fucking good. I literally like can't, last night 6:30 was so amazing. And then I was like, oh, I wanna go out on a really good class before the wedding just to like send me off into this amazing week. So 9:30 this morning, litty bop as my Gen Zers would say. So it was really fun and thank you if you were there and watching this. Probably not, but hey, thanks anyway. And I'm just excited. So today on the agenda, let's look at what we got. Cause it's already 1:30 and I've gotten nothing done. But I'm free the rest of the day. So I'll show you guys my little thing because I didn't write it down today actually. Really different for me. These are IG posts, one on my personal, one on my other one. I wanna make a bachelorette TikTok because I filmed all this stuff to make it fun. Really need to decide what fucking shoes I'm wearing for the wedding. Deciding on dinner, but I think I already did decide that. I wanna start editing vlogs because I'm very behind. I'm gonna run to Trader Joe's, but slash not Trader Joe's because I'm gonna go to the grocery store that I can walk to. Shower, shave, exfoliate for my some spray tan, which is down here. I'm gonna laminate my brows. I may do that in a separate video, but I probably won't. And then I have to go to the dry cleaner and do laundry. And eat. I'm so starving right now.
But I was gonna shower, then I realized, we'll use all my fucking body wash. And I was like, well, I can't shave if I don't have body wash, which I may even splurge and buy some shaving cream, which I never buy. But I'm just gonna go do all the shit that I need to do at the store now to just check it off. And then I have to leave in about 4 hours, 3 hours. Oh my God, I can't, oh my God, I only have 3 hours to do all this. 3 hours before I have to leave for my spray tan. Oh, and I have to pack for the weekend and decide what the fuck I'm wearing to this rehearsal dinner. And I really hope that my dresses come, and I don't think they will because one of them said delivery for tomorrow. And I'm like, yeah, that's not gonna work for me. I'm leaving tomorrow at like the latest, like 10:30 a.m. But I was trying to leave before that. So the odds of me getting delivered, you know, I'm gonna leave at 10:30 and at 10:45, I'm gonna get a text, hey, your package has been delivered. And I'm gonna be like, so
let's get this is the vibe right now. Making green juice the shots. I don't wanna get copyrighted.
Hello. I have my spray tan. It's 8:30 at night. So I had a mishap. I was supposed to get sprayed at 5. I understand I look really scary and really dark, but that's just because you leave the one that I got to the rapid one, so you have a lot of bronzer on when you leave. I look insane! But get this, guys. I'm having a great time today, like checking things off left and right. Boom, 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 boom. Guess what? I kid you not, 10 minutes away from where the woman does her spray tans at her house, and she texts me, my power just went out. I'm like, what? And it clearly didn't come back on by the time I got there. So because I'm gonna start spray tanning again, like working for her, because yeah, I am. We like sat down and talked for an hour. We're like, let's hope that it just like turns back on. It did not. So then I'm like, okay, so I go to Kill Time at Soul because it's like 20 minutes from here. I mean, what else am I gonna do? I'm like not gonna have her family dinner with her. So then she was like, still not on. Estimate is 9. So this is at like 7:15. So I'm like, oh my God, I'm just gonna drive back to Arlington and eat my dinner and then go back because I'm so sick of eating this late. Guys, I shit you not, when I pull into my road, like pull onto my street, she texts me, the power is back on. I literally turn right back around, drive 25 minutes, and get my spray tan. It's now 8:30. I look a hot mess. I'm gonna have to set a fucking alarm to wake up tonight to rinse it off. But I got it. And I just trust her so much that like I'm happy that she did it, because the issue was she could have done it tomorrow morning. However, the rehearsal dinner is at 3. And I'm getting my nails done at 12. Nails and spray tan setting don't mix, number one. Number two, she was like, we could though. And I'm like, I am not pushing that. Well, my hands are all jacked up in every photo I take, no. Also just like sitting, like looking the way I look right now in public, getting my nails done. So I'm very fortunate. I'm just very glad that it's done. Oh, it's over with. And now I will be sitting in my dirty looking face for the next 3 to 3.5 hours. I hope you, I mean, I just got nothing else done tonight, so I'll update the vlog tomorrow and then finish it off, because obvi, I am not vlogging at the wedding. Oh my God, guys, I look insane. But spray tans are the best. Can't wait to go eat my dinner now. Good morning, everybody. In the mirror, I don't feel like I look as dark as I look on this. Well, this is what it looks like. Oh my God, I need to look at myself. Why does the camera make me look so much scarier than my eyeballs see? Okay, calm down, Kallie, you're fine. Okay, I think it's just because it makes like my lips look darker or something weird. My one leg's a little streaky. I must have done a weird job rinsing off last night, so I'm gonna shower again anyway. I have about 45 minutes. Do I look like I've worked out today? No. But I've gotten a lot done. Laundry, packed some nooners, took out the recycling, fixed our plant that really needed some new soil and water. Didn't do a great job, but don't have time to really make it great. So yeah, just kind of a crazy morning. So let's see, what did I do? Oh, I need to do my PT. I need to finish packing, but there's not much else I have left. It's basically like what I have to wear while we're getting ready, the after party outfit, and then what I'm wearing to the rehearsal dinner and pajamas. I think that's it. Yeah, so I'm pretty much packed with that. I just have to like put it, I'm bringing a suitcase because I'm being lazy. We all love a good Vera Bradley bag, right? But sometimes I just don't feel like putting that weight on my arm. So here it is. Nothing I ordered came. So I'm stuck with either this satiny black dress that I have or this dress that I got at Zara that you guys would have seen in another video. I don't even know. Because I really don't have many other options that I want to wear. And it's hot out, so I'm not trying to wear anything long. Oh, I cannot believe what I ordered didn't fucking come. I'm such an idiot. Those are my options. And I have to just stick with it and go with it because there's nothing else I can do about it. I literally ordered 4 dresses on Monday. They're not here. Why am I paying for 2 to 3 day shipping and it not get here? So I feel like my shipping should be free. Why do I look like a full-blown psycho around my mouth in this video? But in life, I don't. Do you guys like that clip? Like, do I have a mustache? Oh my God, and I'm gonna be even darker tomorrow because this tan gets bills for 24 hours. I'm like, no! Something was up with our water last night where it was like burning my face off. Like I literally fell asleep, woke up at 12:30 and rinsed off and then was like, why do I look like this right now? I promise I look better than this in person. Well, whatever. So yeah, I'll show you guys more when I'm like dressed or something. I don't know. Oh my God, my mouth. All right, so excited. Yeah, I look a little less scary than I did this morning. Just put on some, this is the best part about having a tan on. I literally have on some mascara and I put a little bit of concealer on and that's it. I'm excited. So have my bag, like I said, I was just bringing a suitcase because I was being lazy, alcohol, and just obviously another little bag because I don't know, but whatever. So plan today. I am making 2 eggs right now because I won't be able to eat again until probably like 1 o'clock and it's now 10:30. So driving home, because you guys know I love my nail lady, really pushing the boundaries here, but this is why last night my spray tan was such an issue with if I had to schedule it for today, because number one, I like the way a spray tan looks better the second day. Number two, I would have still been sitting looking the way I looked last night. So it's all good, it all worked out and I'm very excited about it. So I'm literally gonna brush my hair and then go get my nails done. Very excited about it. And also my hair, I'm so upset. My scalp got burnt last week somehow. I mean, I did wear space buns the last day of the Bachelorette, but I feel like it was peeling before that, so I don't really know what happened. So my scalp is peeling, which, if that's ever happened to you as someone with long hair, you know, especially long dark hair, that is a problem and it's also so hard to get out. So I literally spent like 20 minutes this morning literally just like scratching my hair with my nail and like peeling. Ugh, just gross. But then I scrubbed the shit out of my head in the shower. So I feel excited. I feel pretty too. Is that bad to say? As something gets stuck in my eye. I don't know, I mean, my lips do look a little, they're heavily contoured with spray tan. I'm just kidding, but whatever. So I'll probably show you guys my nails and then everything from now on is gonna be filmed on my phone because I'm not taking my camera with me because I'm not gonna be using it this weekend. And then once I get my nails done, I'll probably finish off the vlog because, or maybe I'll show you guys my rehearsal dinner outfit and then finish the vlog, but wedding. I'm so excited, so, okay. Goodbye.